Hello, so this is one of those games that it's very, very hard to record and make a let's play because it's all over the place. Now, the problem with this map is that you will find sometimes a lot of loot, sometimes you won't find anything, sometimes you need to move all over the place to do a single quest. Sometimes you'll find something you were not really prepared. So you remember that Maximus War? Yeah, apparently there are two Maximus Wars. Maybe there are even more than two. As you can see, the first one has two books, which I... clearly, I put some timestamps in the other video for it. And as you can see over here, it's 1 out of 7. So I guess the Labian strategy, the Maximum Wars 2, I found it somewhere over here, just as I ended the video. I don't know, the game is just incredible. It makes use of the most tedious quest ever created. I'm surprised we don't have a fetch quest, but considering the combat is turn-based, I'm not sure we'll ever get one. Yeah, those are bandits. That's a nice statue over there. I mean, look at this. This looks like a huge RPG. But the truth of the matter is that this is simple. Like I said, it's wide as an ocean, deep as a puddle. Let's go back over there and I'll show you what else we can do. I don't know. We just have to take this very, very carefully. By the way, you see this entire area over here? There is absolutely nothing to loot in this entire area. I basically wasted 20 minutes searching every corner to not find anything. Oh, actually, I think I found a barrel of something. Yeah, there was an item to loot. A single item. One only. Okay, let's take this quest because I kind of have a plan of what to do this episode.
What do you want? Directions to the old outpost?
Pray, clean up your language in my presence. I am Prince Adrian's envoy.
I have good reason to curse. The brigands from the old outpost haven't let us use Rick. We pay them a toll, which gets higher and higher every day. My brother Servan decided to go negotiate so that we simple peasants could use...
What news is there of...
Nothing. Servan, I wish someone would tell me.
Oh, the old gang will definitely intervene in that little problem. Also, another problem that I have with the game currently is that a lot of the things you do in the game are not actually important. For example, you might search for a treasure for hours at a time and you'll not find anything. As you can see, this is a barrel over here. Oh, that's a rabbit over there. You know what, let's just go to the old camp. We can make it from here. I'll not spend all of my... Hey, that's... Squirrel. I'll not spend all of my time just riding from one place to the other so I can show off a few things. Don't worry, we'll get the chest on the other side of the lake, but for now let's go over here to the refugee camp.
Greetings to you too, my good man.
I think over there. Yeah, let's get over here to the refugee camp because there are a few things I want to do before I kind of search everything. So I think I'll just have to do the quest one at a time, like Flavius the Wisecracker will have to be done in the same video. Destroying the undead and the other stuff will have to be done in the same video, so let's go over here to the camp.
I'd fight a wolf for a piece of raw meat. One cauldron a day for the whole camp and the women and children.
Oh yeah, the cutscene didn't trigger this time. I guess you have to go a little to the south of the map for it to trigger. The world is expertly built.
How could I be so careless?
Yes.
Mother dear,
why didn't you go get
so thankfully.
I can wait. I ate a whole bowl of...
Freshest bread in town, don't be shy. Eat to your heart's content, friends. Come over here,
that's
Norman.
A huge piece of bread.
Hey! Why did he get such a big piece? I want some!
They're at it again.
This is the same size
Calm
bread.
Down. Do you want them to keep treating us like pigs? We're still human beings. No one's taken that from us yet. Got it?
That's some delicious looking bread over there. But where did the bread go? On the floor? I want to eat it if it's on the floor. On the ground, I mean. What? Are you... Are you a halfling? Yeah, details like that make the game a lot more immersive, like the leaves falling down. But then you see that the leaves are actually disappearing in the ground. I mean, they could have stayed on the ground for a few seconds.
So many miserable, hungry people. I wonder how I can help.
Oh.
I don't know, but this, the voice actor for the paladin sounds like a child. And she acts like a child. Which would be funny in other circumstances, but we're kind of doing serious things right now. So this is why I don't like the Unreal Engine and I prefer the cartoony graphics of the other games. Simply put, they don't have the necessary voice acting, quest lines, dialogue, or anything else to kind of support this serious, very, very serious world with people under so many problems. Soup. So in the end, the immersion falls flat. So as you can see, there's nothing to loot over there.
Yes. Why didn't you go get some?
I can wait. I ate a whole bowl of soup last time. There's even a cabbage stalk left. What about you?
I'm not that hungry. How odd. I was very hungry 2 days ago, but now I've gotten used to it.
Oh. But I could eat a piece of bread right now.
Go on then. What are you standing here for?
Well, I'll let the women go first. They need it more.
And the dialogues repeat themselves quite a lot. Okay, let's talk to Belia. Belia.
I'm sorry. May I inquire? What happened to you?
Same as everyone else. I was born in the mage factory. We used broken golems as toys and played hide and seek in the mine shafts. My mother used to read me minor. I lost her book.
Did you lose it near?
No. I definitely had it with me from. So worried my mother's tales will be lost forever.
Okay, we have to say. Oh! Delicious looking soup. Well, it's actually water only. There's only water in that soup. Come on, game. Make me a better bowl of soup. I demand better soup quality.
My belly's been empty for days.
Say, do you need help fixing your house? I don't suppose you have a weepy roof.
I'm sorry, Rato. My home's back in Lorien.
There's life for you. The best artisans in Nostria are stuck here with nothing to do. Hands worth their...
That's an interesting story.
Why did you...
Because of the sensitivity in the game. Looks like... Why did the game revert my sensitivity? No, it didn't revert it, but for some reason it's a lot more annoying.
Why did you...
Oh.
8 years. Trolls are...
Why are you cursed?
8 years I've spent fine-tuning Nostria's champion battle golems. Before Mompatry, I used to work at the Illyrian Mage Factory. Everybody now, a master craftsman, mind you, have been rejected. The disaster made them... This is indeed the time of...
I guess this is just dialogue to kind of enforce the story.
Did you come from the capital? Finally, they've thought of...
No, I didn't know you were starving. You did a great...
I'm Norman, a worker from the foundry.
Prince Adrian sent me. He's...
What's this? Another interrogation? I'm...
Norman, we really...
Forget it. Look at us. Just yesterday, the people I brought here were the Mage Factory's finest artisans. And now everyone's avoiding them like a contagious disease. They've been left to starve outside the city walls.
What? It's only been a day.
There's no way to get through to you, is there, you bastards? And since we're getting nothing from you except beatings...
If only I could do something
about... Listen, I am not a proud... Talk to Mercia over there. She knows... Help my people, and I'll...
Oh!
I don't know, things just don't make sense. I guess they'll be stuck here for more than a day. But they don't seem to be doing so badly. I mean, they have food, they have mostly what they need. And I think it's not so bad to sleep out here. They have even pillows.
Your brother was no help after all. And you promised. Well, hello there.
Prince Adrian tasked me with investigating.
And what of it? I've got nothing to tell. I was on my way back when I saw everyone fleeing as if from a... Now they avoid me like a two-headed leper. I should have made for Floster right away.
What am I supposed to do now?
Norman's who you should talk to about this disaster of yours. The others might keep their tongues.
Yes? How...
No, Honorable Mercia.
My brother has a farm over in Rickville. His name's Garrick. He's a proper farmer. Hard work. I can't make the journey on my own. I'm afraid to travel on the hot. I can see that murderous brigands don't frighten
me. I'll start for Rickville and-
Wait! Why go so-
I beg your pardon?
On the journey here, we came to an understanding with a well-respected countryman. His name is Bludgeon. He promised to get us food some days ago. But Bludgeon has yet to send anything. If you could have a word with him and find out what's taking so long, I'll...
What does that mean, Goof? Do you know who he is, at least?
Sure I do. He's a very respectable fella. The whole of Floster Road belongs to him.
That man is a brigand, a thief, and a murderer.
Will no one help us?
One thing else, like, sorry about that, I'm just thinking out. Look at how nice the feel look behind them with the scarecrows, the grain and all of that. This doesn't look what like a very poor now? Country. Talk to Norman. Norman, we already talked to him because we broke the quest sequence. He doesn't say anything. She told us to go and talk to Norman. Norman doesn't want to tell us anything because we spoke to him earlier. Well, I guess we have to try and get to an understanding with Bludgeon. Bludgeon.
Yes. Why didn't you go get?
Oh no, the road is stuck. I cannot pass. It's an invisible barricade wall. I cannot pass through it.
That hungry.
How I forgive myself.
I was very hungry too.
How could I be so careless? Mother dear.
That's what is this used for? I guess shopping. Chopping vegetables or greens.
Everything will be all right. I'm so hungry, I'd fight a wolf for a piece of raw meat. One cauldron a day. And children paid off. That was. At least we're all alive. Mercy gave us.
Yeah, but I don't really understand how to get there. I guess you have to fight with the brigands. Yeah, I'll have to do that later. You just have to go there and pick up the amulet again. The quest design for this game is abysmal. It's like you're playing a 1 out of 10 RPG. Because remember, I think a good game is actually defined by the way you can actually split the content while making videos. Well, this is kind of like a personal opinion, but... but if you can divide portions of the game to be fun, and even if they're out of context, they can be fun and interesting, then that's
probably
a really good game.
Broad daylight, on the main road, no less.
A robbery.
Aha! Here's the treasure. I should search for a way to unlock the bars.
Yeah, this is the treasure that that guy from the city told us about. I guess there are more levers to press. Looks like we don't go over the dead body. We are very, very full of respect.
Why don't I search around that lantern over there?
It's a very good point. Why didn't I think of that? Oh, a horseshoe and a candelabra. That's interesting.
Something's happening. I must have done something right.
Okay, the character basically gave me the hint how to open, how to complete the puzzle, which is silly. Oh, I have to press space. Let me guess, the skeletons come back alive and I have to kill them. I have killed so many skeletons that this is actually funny.
My amulet, give it to me.
Oh, he speaks.
I expected to encounter a fearsome monster, but you? You're tiny. What's your name?
I never got to grow up. Kidnapper took my brother and me. Took us away and robbed and killed us. I drove him away and hid the amulet. Now give it back!
I need that amulet. Why would I believe you anyway?
A robber. The big man. He grabbed us. Killed my brother and me. Don't believe me? Find him yourself. Ask around and see what you find. Give my amulet back. It was my mother's and it's mine now. It's so cold here.
Timmy? He should be named Timmy after the ghoul in... My dearest Mia from your husband Lyot.
Punished.
Timmy from Warcraft 3.
Give him.
What does the amulet have?
Okay, why was it locked behind such a strange mechanism over here in the ruins if it was his amulet?
It's so cold here. Cannot leave. Can't find him. Must have my revenge.
Well, I guess we're fighting a bird. I guess that's a very sad story, but because of the comical way the dialogue is presented, you get cannot take that seriously. It's so cold, so cold. We are really fighting birds, man. Free archers. Well, I guess free archers are a lot better than our own archers. More or less, I guess they're anarchy. So they're actually copy-pasting units. I think it's 3%. Yeah, 3% more gold. Double shot. Yeah, they do less damage per shot, but they shoot arrows. Bleeding shot, barbed arrows. I like how here the deserters have iron weapons, but in the models they have actually wooden weapons. Oh, okay, that's a fair point. I didn't actually look at the units, but it looks like when they rank up, they get more stuff attached to them. That's an interesting thing. I never observed it because look at the way they look in the portraits. They're exactly the same in the portraits, no matter their rank. So I guess... Yes, raiders. Eagles, where the fuck am I? It's a tiny bird and it does a ton of damage. Why are you... It was supposed to be a griffin, but I guess they discount griffins. They didn't have the budget to introduce griffins, so they called them eagles. Hey, we're actually on the road over there. Why did it start us over here on top? Not sure what to do. I guess I could wait. Yeah, that's fair. Eagles. Yeah, this is one thing that a lot of people complained about. The fights are very fast and not even in Heroes 3 you had units that could walk halfway across the map to kill you. And here it seems like it's happening a lot more often. Yeah, they have proper metal weapons, I think, since they're upgraded, they're rank 3. Well, let's actually use a spell to heal them. Hey, for... Oh yeah, because you cannot really tell what's the... Oh man. You cannot tell how much health is missing from that little bar over there because it's so tiny. The more units you have, the harder this will become to kind of die, to kind of observe. Wait. Yeah, we have to get the eagles out of our flanks first of all. From what I saw, they don't always counter. The spearmen do such a crazy amount of damage. Oh man, this is so stupid, I went... Oh, okay, that was my mistake, maybe I didn't understand the mechanics, maybe I'm an idiot. Again, I don't want to replay the battles a million times just because of mechanics like this that are not really made clear. Yeah. Oh yeah, they can move freely through the control zones. I forgot about that because it's an ability that's not really used a lot. The tactical level in this game is so laughable. This is more like a puzzle fight. Okay, now I know what everything does, and I know that the main point is for Daggles to attack my flank and then the horsemen to attack and retreat. But I know there is an auto save before every battle, Siege of Betrayal. That's. The game is so laughable. The tactical combat is so laughable. This is a super easy combat that is only made hard because of the fact that the game uses arbitrary mechanics, like I'm near the road when I attack them, and then they put me up off the cliff, where they actually have the biggest advantage. Imagine that, a game that not only cheats with its unit composition, but it cheats also with its positioning. I mean, look at the angle we're attacking them from. Do you see anything tall over here? Do you see everything? Oh, okay. Eagles. Eagles the size of a human. No, actually, we start over here. That's another part of the road. I guess I was mistaken. Eh, my bad. And now what will you do? What will the eagles do now? Huh. Nothing. They'll do nothing. The riders have wooden weapons that basically do no damage, but again, because of plot armor, they do a lot of damage. I don't want to attack them with my dogs just yet. I just want to see what the archers will do. Yeah, we need to take care of the eagles first of all. Also, we need to kill one of the horsemen. That will decrease the damage by a huge amount. They'll probably burn and die next turn, I hope. No one died. Well, that's silly. Yeah, the spearmen are kind of like the MVP of the game right now. That would be a very bad idea. Oh, the horseman didn't die. Well, that will do a lot of damage. Looks like we killed one of the horsemen, but we still took the full damage. So that's archers, so those are archers as well. Puzzle fights, I hate puzzle fights so much. I don't get it, where is that stupid war? That zone of defense, why can they bypass everything? They didn't have that ability. Why didn't they get attacked? Oh, because it was... No, I don't care. To be honest, I don't even care. This is one of the worst strategy games I have ever played. Simply put, we cannot even view their stats right now. Let's see. Do they have anything that enables them to bypass the control zone? No, they don't. Oh, the control zone doesn't work if they attack right next to it. What a load of... to be honest, it doesn't really matter. Doesn't even matter. Okay, now my favorite unit will go and kill the raiders. What a stupid game. Many people think this is challenging, but it's not challenging. The only reason this is challenging is because of the simple fact that you are up against some stupid enemy formations, because you cannot select other units, otherwise your morale will drop too much. You're so limited in this game. I wonder how they playtested this thing. I wonder how the playtesters actually said, oh, this is a great game. No, I think the playtesters were probably going to say, oh, have to play this today again. I hope not. Okay, you want to see something funny? You get attacked for bypassing the control zone over there, and you get your units killed. You cannot counter them, and if you go over here to attack, you attack them, right? And all of that just because I wanted to move them a single line, but they didn't get attacked by the King's Watchdogs over here when they... Cannot reach the stupid arches because they have the advantage, because they're on, we are on the ridge. How do the arches have an advantage over us that are, we are sitting on top of the hill? This game is crazy. Why can you not go over here? Control zone. And see, you lose all of your movement points if you just move into a single tile, and you would have lost it. You know what? I think I played too much of the exploration game, and now that I'm actually playing the battles again, I really hate this game. I really hate it. I hate how they ruined all of the combat. But just making everything so stupid. Yeah, that's kind of like my final word about the game. It's stupid. It's so stupid, so idiotically made, so unrealistic, so... I don't think I like anything from the game, to be honest. I lost so many units because of the stupid rules, because I had to fight through a choke point while that just shot me with arrows. Really, this is good game design, in their opinion? Now that I finally reached them, I don't have enough people to do. To attack them. Look, they moved out of the control zone without any problems. without any problems. This is why they only have one counter attack for the control zone. This, the rules for this game are so arbitrarily. You have the high ground. Enjoy it. It's very useful. I wish you could move over here and attack them, but no, you have to attack in a very simplistic manner. Oh, watch this. No, you know what, I'll redo the combat, I'll redo it again, because it's trial and error, that's everything that is. This is the first real combat you have to do in a very long time, and I can skip it, I can wait until I get better at the game, I can wait until I get better items and get more leadership, but I'll not do it, I'll just play it right now and play it and win it. Without losing an entire squad, because that's what I hate about this game so much. How could they mess up everything so badly? Especially the combat. Do you want me to return here another time? Well then, say so. Show me how to distinguish between a hard fight and an easy fight. Why is it so hard? You want me to retreat? What? Tells me the enemy is stronger than me. What? Strong? But, nah. I don't really have access to other troops, so this is everything you have access in the beginning of the game, so I cannot change my troop composition so easy. So the simple fact of the matter is that I'll just have to sacrifice the healers, because the enemy doesn't really care what it loses or not. It doesn't lose. Look at this. Look at this. Of course they bypass the control zone of the warriors because they are flying, right? So there is absolutely no way you can avoid taking damage. And they just wait for you at the edge. Look at the insane range of the archers. And they deal full damage. The game is a bad joke, why do I even bother? Yeah, I'll do this combat another time. Okay, I'll leave the video as it is. I'll not bother deleting or redoing it. I'll leave it as it is to kind of showcase how stupid the game really is. This is not challenging, this is just stupid. Because of the simple fact that the game's mechanics are so broken and so badly balanced, a pair of eagles destroys my entire army because I cannot get past them. Oh yeah, I forgot, we're passing through the control zone and we get attacked and then we can attack them as well. I have no clue how this game made it past the testing phase. Did they actually test anything? Did they actually play the game at all? Because I'm not being outnumbered. I'm not being out-tacticized. The tactic is the same. We're not doing anything wrong. It's just the fact that they put you at such a huge disadvantage that it doesn't even matter with what troops you come in. You'll lose a lot. They have two archers. They have the eagles who will press you in the first round. They will attack you from the first round. He will attack you from the first round. Why does this happen? Why can you not attack anyone from their squad But they can attack you. Almost 3 units from their squad can attack you. There's no strategy over here. There's nothing you can do to make it better. You will defend these guys. Okay, you will be peppered by arrows. You will play very defensive. Okay, let's play very defensive. You will see what happens if you play the game very defensively. The eagles will always go for your weakest unit, which will be the dogs. That means there's no point in actually having the dogs with you. Okay, wait. The whole tactic of the game. Now I have to calculate the exact damage I need to kill all of them, otherwise they simply block my entire army. There's no way to figure out how much they can travel, because in order to see their stats you have to go in this screen over here. So that's 3 movement speed, they will not be able to attack me, okay. You have to go in a separate menu to view their stats. Okay, it's worth it to heal the dogs. Stop messing around with my camera when I cast the spell. And I basically need the damage of 3 or 4 units to kill them. What, the animation didn't even work that time. And see, I can attack and then move. Why is this not all available always to me? Right, right. They just have the perfect composition to mess with your army no matter what your army is. It actually went for the swordsman, that's a big mistake. This is a level 2 unit, why is it so strong in the enemy's hands? Archers have no penalty, of course. Oh yeah, they can move 3 spaces and then attack, that's nice. And where is that stupid control zone? It's not here, it's not triggering for my units. Where is their control zone? Stop moving my camera when I cast a spell, I don't want it. Okay, so we just ate their counter-attack. We still don't kill them. Not like there are any other targets we can hit. Get attacked again and they'll retreat again. Oh, they don't retreat. Oh, looks like they used up their ability. Okay, wait. Six tiles, that's the total range. 6 tiles. You know what? Six tiles. Okay, okay, okay. Move over there. I still cannot engage them. All they have to do is simply move away from me, because... There's not much point into healing them. Yeah, they try to get away after the attack. Arrow to the knee. Additional turn. Oh, that's even better for them. I don't even care at this point. Let's just finish this combat. Tactical combat. Really? Tactical combat. Oh, additional turn. Well, good luck with that one. Good luck with that one as well. Okay. I'm simply getting destroyed by archers because I cannot reach their position. With what? ...52 physical damage. Looks like they don't do a lot of damage sometimes, okay. Now you may be wondering, why didn't I do this in the beginning? Because of the stupid eagles. Look at this now. Moving the control zone. Okay, okay. Let's just say it's only one attack per turn for control zone. Does it say that anywhere? No, it doesn't. Does it explain that? No, it doesn't. Yeah, I need to lose the dogs. They are so bad. Hey, keep your dogs. I don't want to use them ever again. How can a unit be so weak in this game just because it doesn't have... Simply put, the custom design for the terrain makes this battle almost impossible for you to win. Yeah, I think a lot of people will lose the battle as well. But come on, really? Why did they have to make it so unbelievably frustrating? We didn't have such a big difference in troops. It was just the map. Simply put, the map... There was nothing you can do to bypass the first round being attacked. There was nothing you can do to kill the eagles faster. Just proves a big point. You cannot have level 2 units. You just need to take the next level of units. I just have too many level 1 units, that's my only mistake. That's my only mistake, I have to keep repeating it. My only mistake is that I have level 1 units instead of level 2. It's not even that they were not doing a lot of damage, it's the fact that we couldn't reach any enemy. Another one of those statues. Oh, that was actually a nice hiding spot. Did we level up? I think we also leveled up, so we are level 7 right now. Yeah, I guess I was supposed to do that battle later, but it's not hard, it's just annoying. Let me see, what is that? Earth and ice. So to get to the thing I really want to take, I have to take the useless ones. Sure, great idea. 8 points, man. Let's just get all of the spells. As you can see, this is not increasing because we need to complete the quest in order to get the points. I'll just take all of these because I can cast more spells, and let me see. Oh, what? There was this random village over there. Let's just see what's all in this valley over here, and then I'll end the video. Yeah, we can go up that hill. Invisible wall over there as well. Oh, looks like there is a shrine over there. Do I care? Not really. I still cannot believe that the only way to win a battle is to lose troops, because you have no way of avoiding damage. It's opulent mirror and gold. It's unbelievable how they turn a good tactical game from a silly nonsense. I mean, if I will play King's Bounty Crosswalls now, I'll have 10 solutions to every problem just because my character is flexible, but here you have no flexible. It's a linear game, and it's also reflected in the tactical combat. It's not even tactical anymore, it's just combat. Oh, that's a scarecrow. I thought it was a person, but no, that's just a scarecrow. Okay, the view is nice. It's actually calming to see the view. Nice view, calming me down. Feast. Okay, before I end the video, let's just go into his castle and see what we can recruit. No cutscenes, please. I'll
hate
you.
Is that a huge bandit den?
It is. Okay, let's speak with Bolt. That towel, why is it...
Have you seen the way Bonnie looks at Marlena?
Ha! I thought Bonnie was gonna cut her open. How long has she been trying to...
Nice warfare bonus, but... Oh! 20% damage to the bandits, huh? That's interesting. So do the rings actually stack to the... I don't want even to think about it. Let's take more of those and we'll start using them.
Yeah, sure, come close. What are you...
I'm going. I'm really curious to see if they only have bandits over there, because you simply don't have the access to better units. That's another problem. You're losing because you have to fight with what they give you. If this was another game, I would have had 20 types of units at my disposal at least. Yeah, Raiders, Wolves and Eagles. Come on, it's a big chicken. It's just a big chicken. Yeah, they only have bandits over here. Okay, I'll just have to refresh my memory for a little bit. And this battle will stay like that because I just want to showcase how silly the game is. And that will be the last video I do like that. The rest of the videos will be me being happy and winning all the battles and steamrolling everything like it's nothing. Bye.